Hello everyone, I welcome you all to the new session of English Grammar. I hope you all are well and taking good care of your health. Our today's topic is subject and predicate. But before we start our today's topic, we should do a quick revision of what we have discussed in our previous session. So in our previous session, we have discussed about the sentences. So first we should revise the definition of a sentence. So the definition of a sentence is a group of words when arranged in a particular order to make sense is called sentence. This is a definition. We have also discussed the four kinds of a sentence. First is declarative, which simply tells us about something. Next is interrogative, which are used to ask question. Imperative, which makes some request, gives any command or order. And exclamatory sentences are the sentences that show some sudden feeling or emotion. So for example, if I say, the boy is playing with a ball. Which type of a sentence is it? Yes, right. This is a declarative sentence. Because in this sentence, we come to know that there is a boy who is playing with a ball. So, students, in our today's session, we are going to discuss about subject and predicate. So, what are the subject and predicate? Subject and predicate are the two parts of the sentence. Earlier we have discussed the four kinds of the sentences. Now we will discuss the two parts of the sentence. All the sentences are divided into two parts. One is subject and another is predicate. Subject and predicate. So now let us discuss what are the subjects and what are the predicates. So students, as we know, sentences have two parts. One is subject and one is predicate. So what is a subject? Subject always has noun or a pronoun in it. What is a noun? Noun, all the naming words like the name of person, place, animal or thing. It's called noun. And what are the pronouns? Pronouns are the words which are used in place of noun, like he, she, it, they. So it is compulsory to have any noun or a pronoun in a subject. Now predicate. Predicate always has verb in it. It is compulsory to have verb in a predicate. So we can say the subject is the who or what the sentence is about. Means the subject tells who is the doer of the action. And predicate tells what the subject does. What action had been done by the subject, that is told in the predicate part. Okay? The subject is the who or what the sentence is about, and the predicate tells what the subject does. Okay, so let's practice few more subjects and predicates. Here I have a game for you. This is a subject and predicate match game, in which I have few subjects for you and few predicates for you. So here are the subjects. And here are the predicates for you. In this, you have to match the proper subjects with the particular predicates. Our first subject is the kite. Kite is a noun, as we know. So we will match it with the proper predicate. So can you tell me which is the proper predicate for it? Yes, you are right. Flew high in the sky. It goes with flew high in the sky. And as we know that predicate has verb in it. So what is a verb in this part? Flew. Flew is a verb. Now next, the strawberries, and it goes with tasted sweet. My mom, it goes with made me grilled cheese. Last is a shark, and it goes with is very dangerous. So I hope students, with the help of this exercise, you have understood how we match a proper subjects with the proper predicates. Okay? So students, I hope you have finally understood what a subject and predicate are. So till then, take the reference of this discussion and try to solve your book exercises. I will see you in the next session. Till then, take care. Thank you and bye.